The United Nations says it's doing everything possible to get civilians out of the Mariupol steel plant in southeastern Ukraine. Its Secretary General met with President Volodymyr Zelensky in Kyiv as the capital city was hit with fresh shelling.
Inside Mariupol's last pocket of defence, the Azovstal steel plant, a makeshift hospital faced a fresh onslaught of shelling and artillery fire, with hundreds of wounded inside. According to a local official, they're the heaviest strikes on the site yet. But the UN Secretary General in Kyiv, after visiting Moscow, says an escape out of the apocalypse is still possible, telling President Zelensky Putin has agreed in principle to allow a UN and Red Cross evacuation.
We are doing everything we can to make it happen.
More than 8,000 cases of suspected war crimes have now been identified, according to Ukrainian investigators. Many of them in Bucha and Irpin, where the horrors of war became painfully real to the Secretary General.
The war is an absurdity in the 21st century.
US President Biden set to ask Congress for another $33 billion to help Ukraine maintain its fight for freedom.
And the cost of this fight, it's not cheap, but caving to aggression is going to be more costly if we allow it to happen.
The war is now entering its ninth week, and like many cities, the sight and sound of missile strikes continues in Kyiv. Cleanup underway in Zaporizhia, but there's an overwhelming damage bill. President Zelensky believes Russia's invasion has so far cost Ukraine more than $800 billion. In London, Kariane Greenbank, 9 News. We'll be right back.